Hi, Alan Stratton from As Wood Turns. In this video, I will show you how to make version 2 of the infinite axis chuck. The infinite axis chuck enables us to make eccentric turnings using a ball in a standard PVC fitting. The upgrade now enables us to do the discs that we did before, but now also bottle stoppers or eccentric spindles that were a little bit more difficult with version 1. The parts are very familiar. Still a threaded wood faceplate. I recommend the threading because for a more solid base, but it does have an option for a dovetail fitting for a scroll jaw. One half of a PVC fitting, a very similar ball except that it's sized to almost exactly fit into the PVC fitting. And then inside the PVC fitting, we've added body putty to provide a complete friction surface to the ball. On top of the ball then goes a fitting to provide friction and adjustment from the top. And then finally, if you don't do a bottle stopper, you put on another part to provide just a regular surface for discs and for broaches and such. So let's see how to make version 2 of the infinite axis chuck.
The first step is to prepare the threaded wood faceplate. I already have videos on making these, so I'll speed through this part as a review. I've mounted a 2-inch thick piece of poplar to the face of my scroll chuck jaws and held in place with the live center. This is enough to turn around and to cut a tenon on which to reverse mount shortly. Then flip it around into the chuck jaws and tenon to drill the first hole. Since my spindle is 1¼ by 8 threads per inch, this hole is 1⅛ inch diameter. Although this is not required, I found it easier to drill it entirely through the poplar. Following this, I can run the tap through the hole. I've done so many faceplates now, it seems almost second nature. To preserve and extend the life of the threads, I'm flooding them with thin CA glue. After thoroughly drying, I'm running the tap through the wood again. While the CA glue dries, I'll start the retention gasket. Since I have some, I'm using 3/4 inch high-density polyethylene. The high-density polyethylene tools like butter. I need to fit one side to the top of the PVC's ring, the other side to the inside of the PVC coupling. Having an exact fit to the PVC coupling will keep it in place while in use. I can use this tenon to remount the polyethylene to tool the opposite side. A skew as a scraper is my primary tool. Now for the ball that is essential to operating this chuck. This is a familiar process that I have previous videos for. This time I'm using my paper cheat sheet to measure out for an octagon. From the octagon, it's a short bit of rounding over for a rough ball. With the ball roughed out, I'll switch to a cupped faceplate. I'm using my live center with a drilled out rubber stopper for pressure from the tailstock. The ball is marked at its largest diameter, then turned 90 degrees for mounting to the faceplate. Then, carefully, with shear scraping, I'm cutting it back but leaving the diameter mark. Then mark a new diameter and rotate the ball 90 degrees to the diameter mark again. Reduce the high spots and leave the diameter mark with shear scraping. I'll keep marking, rotating, and shear scraping until I'm happy with the ball and it is the right size to fit inside the PVC coupling. No sanding the ball this time. The last thing is to actually mess up the ball a bit by cutting a little bit of a tenon to match my scroll chuck jaws. With the ball finished, I'm going back to the PVC fitting. Since I already cut mine in half for the first chuck, I only need to trim it. The PVC opening is an expansion mount on the chuck. I'm using a threaded faceplate on the live center to maintain even pressure. Then center the fitting and make a new parting cut. Back to the threaded wood faceplate, now mounted upside down on my spindle threads. The final details are to finish fitting the faceplate to the spindle. Mine requires a shallow recess on the headstock side and just a little taper to the starting threads. Then face off the bottom to clean it up. Then invert it to clean up the top surface. Now I need to cut a groove to fit the PVC fitting. This only needs to be 1/4 to 1/2 inch deep. Then glue the PVC to the faceplate. I used medium CA glue. Back to the ball. With the ball now mounted to the scroll chuck using that small tenon, I can drill out a 1 inch hole for the mounting tenon. Next, I'm turning down the mounting tenon and fitting it to the ball. Since I'll be using this chuck for bottle stoppers, I'll drill this mounting tenon to be tapped for a 3/8 inch bolt later. Then part off the mounting tenon and glue it into the ball. Now for the messy part. The PVC has been glued to the faceplate, and the ball has a handy tenon on it for a handle. I've wrapped the ball with masking tape to exactly fit the PVC coupling, then wrapped it with kitchen plastic wrap. I've also put a small piece of scrap wood over the center hole in the faceplate. I'm mixing some auto body putty, I know it as Bondo, in a small sandwich bag. Then cutting off a corner and using the bag to squeeze the putty into the base of the PVC fitting. Then using the retention gasket and the PVC ring, press the plastic covered ball into the auto body putty. Let it harden. Then take it apart and clean up a little putty that is too high on the inside of the PVC fitting. Next, turn the project mount. This is a piece of hardwood to fit the mounting tenon. This is a replaceable part as it will be chewed up with use in the chuck. It needs both a 1-inch hole and a 3/8 inch hole. Then it is glued to the mounting tenon. Now I've put the ball back into the chuck. I have a 3/8 inch tap to cut threads for the mounting bolt. If your bottle stoppers use a different size, then standardize on what you will use. Since we now have a bolt for mounting bottle stoppers, we need additional mount for brooches or discs that will be mounted with double stick tape. This has a center hole sized to the outside of the project mount and a center hole threaded to fit the 3/8 inch bolt. Finally, drill a hole to fit your lathe breakout bar through the wood faceplate. This will come in handy to unscrew the chuck in use. In use, any adjustment to the chuck produces a new turning axis that is not parallel to the lathe's turning axis. In geometric terms, a skew line will not intersect another line. These axes may intersect inside the ball, but never outside. So they're close enough for me to be skew axes for my purposes. The new infinite axis chuck is now ready to use for a wide variety of eccentric projects, such as those starting with a flat disc for brooches, pendants, refrigerator magnets, or such as those starting with a short spindle mounted to the bolt for bottle stoppers and handles, and for the really wild and crazy turner, larger spindles for exotic eccentric forms. We'll see you again next week for another wood turning video. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and please tell your friends. Keep wearing your full face shield. Goggles are not enough. Until next time, this is Alan Stratton from As Wood Turns. Keep on turning.